Before we start our topic today, please smash the like button and subscribe to help the channel grow. What is St. Elmo's fire? St. Elmo's fire is a persistent blue glow that occasionally appears near pointy objects during storms. The name is something of a misnomer, as the electric phenomenon has more in common with lightning or the northern lights than it does with flame. Captains of the seas and skies know St. Elmo's fire best, as the ethereal light has long been sighted clinging to the masts of ships and more recently the wings of planes. Mariners have noted the spectacle for thousands of years, but only in the last century and a half have scientists learned enough about the structure of matter to understand why the phenomenon takes place. It's not gods or saints that kindle the enigmatic fire, but one of the five states of matter, plasma. Reports of blue lights dimly flickering from the rigs of ships date back to antiquity, when the Greeks and Romans interpreted the sight as visitations from the demigod twins Castor and Pollux. Considered saviors of those in danger, the twins' apparition would have come as a hopeful sign to sailors weathering a storm. The phenomenon later got its modern name from Saint Erasmus, or Saint Elmo for short, who lived in the 3rd century. Saint Elmo gained fame as the patron saint of sailors in intestinal distress, after he was reportedly killed by disemboweling. Sailors prayed to him in moments of distress and continued to interpret the glow of St. Elmo's fire dancing and hissing on the tips of their boats as a favorable omen. What causes St. Elmo's fire? A scientific understanding of St. Elmo's fire became possible only after British chemist and physicist William Crookes produced what he called radiant matter through his work with vacuum tubes in 1879. The discovery of the electron came 2 decades later, revealing that the world was made of more than neutral atoms. Finding that atoms contained smaller, charged particles proved essential to understanding why Crookes's matter shined, launching the whole new field of plasma physics. Plasma occurs when excess energy breaks up atoms in a neutral gas to create a charged gas. One way to create plasma is with heat. For example, heating solid ice breaks molecular crystals into liquid water, and boiling liquid water liberates water molecules to rise as a gaseous vapor. Continue to dump energy into the vapor by heating it past 21,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 12,000 degrees Celsius, for instance, and the atoms in the water molecules get roughed up, losing their electrons and becoming charged ions. This point represents the transition from a gas, a cloud of neutral particles, to a plasma, a cloud containing many charged particles. Electricity can tear up gas molecules and make a plasma more easily than heat can, which is the key to St. Elmo's fire. During a storm, friction builds up extra electrons in certain parts of clouds, generating powerful electric fields that reach the ground. A strong enough field can theoretically break air down into a plasma anywhere, but in practice, sharp points, such as the mast of a ship, tend to concentrate the field, stripping electrons from atoms to leave behind charged ions in especially high numbers near sharp places. Once the air around a mast has partially transformed into a plasma, St. Elmo's fire shines via a process called corona discharge. As the electric field slings electrons around, they knock into neutral particles and agitate those neutral particles into a more energetic state. Imagine some bully going through the schoolyard kicking all the kids, said Christina Lynch, a plasma physicist at Dartmouth College in New Hampshire. They get all excited, and then they have to relax. To cool down, the excited particles emit a photon of light with a particular energy and color. For nitrogen and oxygen, which dominate in Earth's atmosphere, that burst of light burns blue and violet, respectively. St. Elmo's fire isn't lightning. While St. Elmo's fire tends to take place in stormy conditions, it's a distinct phenomenon from lightning. A lightning bolt's glow contains blue and purple for the same reason, but it also shines white, a mixture of many colors as it heats the air around it. Advertisement. The colorful lights of the aurora get their glow from relaxing particles as well, although the electrons that excite these particles ultimately get their energy from the solar wind, rather than electrically charged clouds. Many also confuse St. Elmo's fire with ball lightning, another incandescent phenomenon known for millennia. While those hovering spheres of light remain poorly understood, the two events have been reported together, as in this mountaineer account from 1977, reported in the Journal of Scientific Exploration. Just under me, there was a dilapidated building. I could see still tongues of light blue flame on every point of steel framework which protruded from the ruins. The flame was of various sizes. The higher was the point, the larger was a tongue of flame on it. Still lower, at a height of 4,000 to 4,100 m, 1,300 to 1,350 feet, lightning was flashing. Orange balls of the size of a soccer ball were flying by the wind on the background of black clouds. Is St. Elmo's fire dangerous? Fortunately for hikers and sailors, St. Elmo's fire doesn't burn or present any immediate danger beyond the potentially stormy weather itself. Engineers, however, must take corona discharge into account when designing electrical equipment, particularly power lines, as unwanted instances of St. Elmo's fire can sap valuable electricity. To minimize that effect, many long-distance power lines feature hoop-like corona rings around pointy areas such as the tips of towers and poles. These rings keep the electric field from getting concentrated enough to produce a lot of plasma. In other cases, engineers have found ways to use corona discharge to their advantage. The process is involved in the production of ozone, an industrial disinfectant. Corona discharge also plays a role in creating the charged surfaces needed inside a photocopier. While researchers have demystified the phenomenon and put it to work in modern technology, the harmless but captivating glow of St. Elmo's fire still has the power to astonish bystanders, just as it has for millennia. What causes the strange glow known as St. Elmo's fire? Is this phenomenon related to ball lightning? William Beatty is an electrical engineer who has designed numerous science exhibits for museums. He is the creator of the Science Hobbyist webpage and is a member of the Mad Science Network. He offers the following explanation. St. Elmo's fire is a type of continuous electric spark called a glow discharge. You've seen it many times before, since it is almost exactly the same as the glows found inside fluorescent tubes, mercury vapor streetlights, old orange display calculators, and in Eye of the Storm plasma globes. When it occurs naturally, we call it St. Elmo's fire, but when it occurs inside a glass tube, we call it a neon sign. St. Elmo's fire and normal sparks both can appear when high electrical voltage affects a gas. St. Elmo's fire is seen during thunderstorms when the ground below the storm is electrically charged, and there is high voltage in the air between the cloud and the ground. The voltage tears apart the air molecules, and the gas begins to glow. It takes about 30,000 volts per centimeter of space to start a St. Elmo's fire, although sharp points can trigger it at somewhat lower voltage levels. St. Elmo's fire is plasma. A normal gas is composed of molecules. The molecules are composed of atoms, which in turn are composed of electrons and clusters of proton particles. If the electric force applied to each bit of gas is greater than a certain level of voltage, it causes the electrons and protons of the gas molecules to be pulled away from each other. High voltage transforms the gas into a glowing mixture of separate proton clusters and electrons. We call this mixture of particles by the name plasma, and it is conductive. It also fluoresces with light. The color of the glow depends on the type of gas involved. If we lived in an atmosphere of neon gas, then St. Elmo's fire would be red/orange, and lightning would be white with orange edges. Our atmosphere is nitrogen and oxygen, and this mixture glows blue/violet when exposed to high voltage fields. If a neon sign tube was filled with nitrogen/oxygen instead of neon, it would light up blue/violet rather than red/orange. Is this phenomenon related to ball lightning? No one knows, because no one knows what ball lightning is, and it might not be a spark at all. St. Elmo's fire is sometimes mistaken for ball lightning. Among other differences, ball lightning can drift around like a soap bubble, while St. Elmo's fire always remains attached to an object. Air is a good electric insulator. However, if an electric field at the end of a metal rod is strong, air molecules in its vicinity are ionized and charges stream off the end of the rod. Since an electric field is intensified in regions of high curvature, discharges are intensified at the end of pointed metal rods. These corona discharges give a faint light that is visible in the dark. St. Elmo's fire is an example of a continuous corona discharge. It is not a form of lightning. The luminous glow of St. Elmo's fire is sometimes observed at night from the tops of ships' masts when electrified clouds are overhead. The mast appears to be on fire but does not burn. St. Elmo's fire tends to occur toward the end of a thunderstorm. Mariners have traditionally interpreted it as a good omen. St. Elmo is the patron saint of sailors, but St. Elmo's fire is not bound to the sea. It has been observed atop tall steeples. My brother once saw it envelop metal pipes outside his home. St. Elmo's fire, luminosity accompanying brush-like discharges of atmospheric electricity that sometimes appears as a faint light on the extremities of pointed objects such as church towers or the masts of ships during stormy weather or along electric power lines. It is commonly accompanied by a crackling or hissing noise. St. Elmo's fire, or corona discharge, is commonly observed on the periphery of propellers and along the wing tips, windshield, and nose of aircraft flying in dry snow, in ice crystals, or near thunderstorms. Various flight procedures, in addition to mechanical and electrical devices designed to reduce the accumulation of electrical charge, are utilized as safeguards in preventing or controlling these discharges. The name St. Elmo is an Italian corruption, through St. Elmo, of St. Erasmus, the patron saint of Mediterranean sailors, who regarded St. Elmo's fire as the visible sign of his guardianship over them. The phenomenon was considered to be a token of good luck, because it is most pronounced near the end of a storm. Thank you for watching. See you again for another interesting facts and amazing stories, and also please like and subscribe.